Hey guys, how's it going? Today we're going to be doing some Hollow Knighting, and as you can see, I've done a little bit of gaming in the meantime, in between these videos. I have gotten a lot more upgrades, unlocked a lot more places on the map, which I'll flash in a sec, got some cool new power-ups, upgrades, and such. Map is looking pretty swag and big now. Here's about as far as I've gotten. Yep. We're right here in Queen's Gardens. So we're just gonna hop over, check out Freddie Mercury's place, and then we're probably gonna get out. And that's about all we might have time for today, but you know what? Let's just get into it. It's Corna for over there. Maybe turn him down a bit. Nah, that should probably be fine. And let's go. So now we have like double jump and stuff. And we should be able to game out pretty hard. So I'm actually pretty bad at this game, so if I choke on some boss fights, just, you know, it's about as expected. But I tend to have to focus kind of a lot when playing Hollow Knight, so don't expect too much in the way of incredible commentary or anything like that. But yeah. So we're just going to be heading over here, and we have this little area in the top left that we want to be looking at. Should be some dudes over there that we're going to slay. You know what? That's to be expected. Get a little bit of extra soul here. Gonna need it. If you want to know what that trail behind us is, it's this charm. Heroic odor basically means we're pooping or farting or some mix in between that we don't really need to talk about. Yeah, here we are. Can we go in to the left? Or not. Looks like that place is blocked off, so... Let's see, where else can we go? Let's check our map of runes. Let's see, so green path, this area, we've already basically done most of it. We could head to the City of Tears. Where can we go? Well, I'm actually in the business of collecting some soul, but that doesn't really make for good content, does it? Well, I guess we can head over to Crystal Peak, maybe. See what's going on over there. And maybe we can hit up the Grub Daddy as well. That sounds terrible, but I trust you, it's actually very reasonable. I'll just be showcasing some of the miscellaneous stuff, and maybe we'll try to find a boss if I don't just die on platforming. No, I really thought I was gonna be okay with that, but... this isn't how it usually goes, I promise. Might be a little bit of cap in that statement, but... Yeah, let's just take it slow. Whatever, guys. No big D. No big D. Alright, let's go head over to our guy, our train station fella. And, go on from there. But yeah, I've actually been super enjoying Hollow Knight, and this game is a ton of fun when you're not just running into stuff and dying. But, you know, I've come through a bunch of bosses, cut through them, unlocked a ton of new areas, yeah, it's just been a great experience. I'm super loving this game, as evidenced by my playing a little bit extra in between the last video and this video. So why don't we go take a stop here, jump over to this other side, say hi to Mr. Ghost Dude who we just passed, and head on up to Crystal Peak. Gonna just pick up some soul. This is a new area that we recently unlocked. I say recently, but that is definitely relative. And we use our super jump to traverse this area, or just die. That's something we do a decent amount of too. Again, I say we, but I just mean myself. It's just myself. I'm the only one dying here. So now we're here, Crystal Peak. Got some dudes that we can kill. Got some stuff that we can fight, but I've already cleared most of this out, so I won't bore you too much. Just make my way downtown. Walk it fast. Have some faces pass. I hope I don't get copyright stricken or anything. So, you know. Next stop here. We just gotta head up and to the right, and then we'll have a little tree that we can slash and get some soul. It's not the right place. There's a mini boss around this area, but we do not need to deal with him right now because, well, we already killed him. So let's just go here. Sorry, corrupted miners. Alright, so we just gotta head to... That's very rude. We just gotta head to the right and down a bit. It seems. Let's just say goodbye. Maybe eliminate some of these gentlemen. Should be to the right here. And let's dream nail this. Skadoosh. And oh, our farts killed him. That's pretty gross. But yeah, we're just collecting this to power up our soul. We got some attunements. Looks like that is 600 essence. Pretty swag. Got our poop finishing off these dudes. Again, I don't actually know if it's really poop or anything, but yeah, looks like that's a different area. So why don't we head over here? All right. Last of these orbs. Yep, that was the last of them. So we basically finished what we wanted to do over here. And that's pretty much all we've got for the crystal mines. I do not know if there's anywhere else I can progress at the very moment. We've already reached Hallinus Crown. So we'll probably just be taking our gracious leave. Falling all the way down. Let's miss our stop. So we're just gonna head on through here. Tag this bench. And be on our merry way. Oh, I did not know we could one-shot those guys. take great joy in doing so. And let's just head back to Dirtmouth. In the meantime, take joy in this incredible supermanning. Didn't see anything. So we just saved her in their minds, basically. Oh. Take a stab at Mr. Guy. Huh. He's showing some concern for us, thankfully. Hashtag, thank you, sir. Read a little bit of poetry, maybe. Appreciating us, the Hollow Knights. No, you're welcome. So this place has gone infected, which is why it looks really weird and gross. The enemies also look really weird and gross. And they blow up. Which I actually forgot about. So thank you, me, for reminding myself. Hopefully I don't die randomly like that. That'd be pretty embarrassing. Just to reroute some dudes. So these guys also drop little annoying stuff. So we'll, you know, we'll use our horizontal ground and just, you know, finish them off. Really sweet. Go head over to Grub Papa. Give me that loot. Ooh, what could this be? Helena seal, very nice. You can trade them for some cash somewhere else. Wow. We really have gotten a ton of these dudes, actually. Pretty sweet, pretty sweet. I don't know if we have anything to do in this immediate area, so why don't we just head back to Dirtmouth and see where we gotta go. Showcase my incredible bossing ability, actually, so that would be pretty nice. Actually, what the heck I gotta do? Little 21 Jump Street or whatever. We do need to explore Deep Nest, but I'm actually pretty afraid of that place. So fungal waste. Meh. Although I suppose we could fight a dream version of a boss. That could be pretty fun or pretty painful, depending on who you are. It'd be pretty painful for me, to be honest. Yeah, screw it. Why the heck not? So let's go take that stag station and let's go fight the false knights. Just gotta equip some of the correct stuff here. Don't really care about Sprintmaster, don't really care about you, blah blah blah. So equip this maybe. Dream Shield maybe. I'll probably need this. And Compass, I think we know our way around good enough to not need that. So we'll have Mark of Pride, more range. Deep focus. Don't actually want that. I would like the quick focus charm. So quick focus there, and that actually frees up some other charm slots. Maybe increased soul. Sounds pretty good. Let's just see if there's anything else better. Yeah, and increased soul sounds pretty good. So I'm gonna run with this, and then we'll just be bossing a bit. So basically, we're just gonna be getting to this area, right where my marker is. And that's actually where we fought one of the first bosses of the game. But with this Dream Nail that we have, this is the Dream Nail Slash, we are gonna be able to fight a reborn version of him. And he does seem pretty tough from, you know, the time that I actually tried to fight him and then I instantly died. So we'll just see if we can make that happen. And that'll, I guess, be our boss for the video. But yeah, everywhere's infected, everywhere's freaking gross. But from Stag Station, we just head up and we take the first left. I really hate those birds, they do explode, just gotta keep that in mind. And in we go. So yeah, all these corrupted enemies. Not a huge fan. What can you do? This poor guy. So bright. Man, feel bad for the corrupted bozos. I thought. Sometimes you gotta blow them up, because, or blow them from range. Because if you melee them, well, you get kind of murked. This was where we fought the original boss. No one in there now, but if we head up here. See that? That's where you can refight this boss. So, this weird looking baby dude, that is the reborn version of the False Knight. Let's do this. So we're here in the spirit realm, or mirror dimension, or whatever it's really called, I kind of forget. But in here, we'll face our greatest foe. As of this video, I guess. So, let's see. Let's see if I can pull him up in the boss wiki area. Mantis Traitor, oh my god. Marmu, these are some of the dudes that we fought before. Mollurks, Husks. Well, I should be pretty far up there. This is one of the first boss that we fought. This is the False Knight. A maggot driven mad by strange force inhabits a stolen armored shell. So this is the guy that we fought. This is the maggot that was inside of him. So yeah, that's actually what's inside of the suit of armor. But here we go, we're gonna be fighting him. We're gonna be probably dying to him and then refighting him, so we'll see how everything goes. Let's do this. Jesus. Okay, don't heal there. God, that does a lot of damage. That does a lot of damage. That does a okay. So as you can see, we don't actually die. We just get respawned, but without any soul or anything. So, whew, let's just give it another go, because that was actually pretty embarrassing. I think I just need to take it a little bit slower and not try to go for as many heals. Even though we do have the quick heal charm, we actually don't have enough time in between, so let's just try to do our best to not get hit. Oh my god. How do you get in on this guy? Okay, take it slow, take it slow. I just need to pick and choose better times to get in on him, I think. So we're gonna be going back, redoing this again, we're gonna be doing this till we freaking get him, guys. You're gonna see me failing a lot because I'm a noob, but hey, let's try this. so dummy thick. Oh my god. I'm just getting hit by these freaking little baby. Oh, okay. We're not getting tilted, guys. Slightly at an angle, getting propelled, if you could say that. We're not getting tilted. I gotta take it slow, guys. Figure out when to strike. Figure out when to just run away. And it'll be good. And we gotta watch out for the falling thing as well. So take our two free hits. Jump. Jump. He's dummy thick. Gotta remember that. He's gonna be jumping here. One more time. Just gotta keep dodging. Jesus. Oh my god. I actually don't even think we gained soul during the fight, so I think my soul catcher is actually completely useless, but holy cow. I think I've got the patterns down, actually, so I just need to execute, and also, I'm pretty sure when he jumps directly at me, I need to keep run past where he jumps from, so I actually need to overshoot my dashes sometimes. Take our two free hits. Take our one free hit. Jump here. Okay, it's fine. Yeah, so like that, I need to jump forwards there. I need to not get hit by that. And I'm okay. You know, embarrassing show, but at least I got my point across. So when he slams for the shockwave, I jump over the shockwave, get a hit in. He jumps forward, I dodge, get hidden, or run past, get hidden. Is there anything beyond here? Alright, it's just an alternate route. Let's do this. Oh, an extra hit, actually. Yeah. Jump over here. I should have run past there. Didn't go far enough. Okay, when he jumps at like right at me, I need to dash forward or dash back behind him. Gotta keep in mind, guys. Gotta keep those dashes on the ready. So far, I haven't even gotten the knockdown phase yet. It's pretty embarrassing. But we're getting there. Hopefully we don't actually fall out of the Shadow Realm. That'd be double embarrassing. Just get our three hits in. Let's get instantly hit, like a noob. Instantly get hit again. Again. Okay. Should have overshot there. Okay. Yeah, my in-game commentary is probably not the greatest because I'm just focusing on not getting walloped, absolutely like demolished by this dude. So, you know, apologies for that. But yeah, let's just try to keep this going. Okay. Stay focused, stay focused. That's bad. I should have dashed there. Ooh, don't stay too high up. Don't stay too high up. And watch out for the falling rocks. Okay. It's okay, guys. Just a scrub. Doing scrubby things. No big deal, no big deal. Okay, here we go. Yeah, you better run. I should have ran past there. I should have stayed out of range there. Should not try to pogo off him. And I should have ran past there. When I see him, like, going up and towards me, I need to start dashing towards him. Be aggressive. I also need to limit my careless jumps, because, you know, just a bad habit, honestly. So let's do this. Come on. Okay, really bad start. Get our hit in there. We are blind. To do a dash there instead of getting, you know, mangled. Just gonna jump here. Oh, I dashed the wrong way. Oh man. Okay. That was, you know, at the beginning, I really wasn't playing it well, but I just need to remember to keep my distance and honestly just focus on dodging over anything else. The damage can come as slowly as it can, as slow as it needs to be, but the HP never comes back. So just gotta keep that in mind. Jump here. Alive right at this moment. Just got barely grazed by his bum. I forgot to double jump. Didn't get far enough away. And I'm getting hit by the rocks. Okay. This time, I feel like the environment really did me in. Like, I just wasn't watching in for where the rocks are falling. So, lesson learned, when not jumping, stay close to the ground. Because the ground is where the safety is from the rocks. More time to react means you're not going to get hit as much. Don't dash into him. A lot of things I should just not be doing. Yeah, I'm just standing at the wrong ranges. Gotta adapt. That's pretty much it. But my draw is that I have two useless charms. So... I'm also having some excuses, perhaps. Okay, maybe I need to dash the other way, just walk behind him. I'm super dead. Just kill me. But you know what? That happens. So, we slash and we go again. Stay focused. Alright, I wondered if I could get double hits in there, but really should just not. I'm also gotta dash away when he starts jumping, because dashing, I think, puts you in safety. So, yeah. Okay. again, I need to work on my habits. I have to dash instead of jump. Even though dashing could send me to a rock, it's way less of a risk than just jumping and getting hit by his slam every time. So I think I just need to change my defensive option, really. Wrong spacing again. Jumping instead of dashing. And dash to a rock. I know it's painful for you, it's painful for me too. It's one thing to talk into a microphone about what you're doing wrong and how to fix it. It's another thing to actually fix it. Standing inside the man's body. Just a dumb move. But the beginning was going okay. Conscious of space, conscious of dashing. I mean, what else can we do? Bad timing on everything. As you can tell, I am not an elite gamer in this style of game. I've not really done any Metroidvanias, to be honest. This might be a faster way to reach the station. Yeah. Okay. I'm getting pwned by those rocks. Maybe I need to be up slashing while I'm... No, I just kind of gotta see where they are and dodge them. Kind of just basic stuff there. I'm impressed that downward slash reached. But as I kind of understand how I need to be playing. But you know what they say, talk less, game more. So I'm just focus up. Tense mode. God, I need to just jump away and focus on living there. I'm being way too dumb with my spacing.
Whatever. Just type bad. Recurring theme, if you haven't noticed. Waiting to dodge, like right before he hits me. But I need to just dodge this straight as soon as he just goes up into the air. Gotta work in forcing that habit in. On those dodges. So greedy, trying to stay in hit when I should just be running. Stay walking, man. Stay walking. And again, out with the greed, in with the good. Oh my goodness gracious. Okay, well I guess we do hit a bit of soul there. But not really enough to actually use. Okay, we got him down a phase for the first time though. Which is honestly, that's progress. Play smart, get some dashes. Keep playing safe. Keep playing safe. It's gotta be my mantra. I have no idea what killed me. Is his butt hurt box that actually that big? Okay, you know what? I kind of choked there, so yeah, that's not a good loss. At least we're consistently breaking him. Just have to do it without taking much damage. Ouch. Jeez. Misplays. He jumps more in ground in round two. He jumps faster, I think. So just gotta stay grounded a bit when not necessary to jump. Also just don't take unnecessary damage as usual. Like that. Need to play the ranges, man. Need to play the ranges. Don't prioritize damage over health. I also need to stop holding forward, because that's just what I'm doing, and I'm running into him. I'm so stupid. Need to dash on sight, bro, on sight. He just jumps at you. Holy cow. But yeah, take too much damage. Just get punished for that. So grounded, or stop saying so aerial. Need to be grounded sometimes to dodge his jumps. misplayed so much in second phase, but first phase is really good. grounded.
Yeah.
There's a joke somewhere in there about hashtag your parents to you or something. Jumps at me, I just have to dodge, man. I can't just keep walking like that. Have to dodge. Gotta stop holding forward too. Thank you. Pretty close. Damn. So green on the second stock. God, I really hate those rocks. I also hate the weather I'm playing. Move. Oh my god, so many bad hits, but hey, broke second stage. So bad. I kept running into the big downward slash. I was just like scared of the falling rocks, but I really can't be. I just gotta run instead, I guess. Freaking dash, man. Freaking dash. I'm just gonna switch Charm Lotus really fast. Because it feels kind of tilting having these pretty bad charms. Yeah. Oh my god, dude, that heal was so bad. It's unreal how bad that heal was. Holy cow. So bad. Kidding me. Strength to protect the others. When I saw that knight sleeping, safe in his big armored shell. It wasn't madness that drove me to it. I just wanted it. But in the end, strength cannot save you, then what can? Let's see. No soul left in that guy. Thank you so much for watching this painful, painful fight. But if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. And make sure to like the video. I psycho boss fights. See you later.